Hello then, welcome to another insightful episode of African Student Voices on AETV, the voice of higher education in Africa, and I'm your host, Ajaman Otrodako. So you bear with me that very soon we'll have students resuming school, right? And the issue is the prime safety and security of students. Would it be the responsibility of management or the students' own issue? And what do students expect to be safe on campuses? Or as we have anybody on campuses, and we don't want that though, but what do we need as students to journey our way through the COVID-19's repercussions on campuses? And we mean the studio have student leaders to discuss the way forward. That if we resume school today, this is what we want to do to keep ourselves safe. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back.
One of the universities set up in our pre-independence era, the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology. Our international reputation has and continues to soar as a reference point in matters of science and technology, research and education. We believe that the future belongs to those who have sound technology acumen.
I love USA.
I love KNUSD.
Welcome back to African Student Voice on AETV. I'm your host, Ajaman Otrodako. And before we went for the pause, I was talking to you about journeying your way through the repercussions of COVID-19 on campuses. And, you know, campus life normally was interesting. It was lovely. And now COVID-19 brings a whole new narrative to campus life. But before we delve into this, let me introduce to you who I have with me in the studio today. So, first guest is Kojo Nyedwala from Central University. Kojo, welcome to African Student Voices.
Thank you.
And I have with me, she's been here before, and the lovely Len Willis from the Knapsford University. And I have with me Gabson Gapoya Ebenezer, president for the Ghana Union of Professional Studies in Ghana. Gab, welcome to African Student Voices.
Thank you.
Sure. I mean, this is very important. We're looking at how we can psych students in this new era of COVID-19 and how they could live on campuses. Let's start with the old campus life and the new campus life. So Kojo, tell us, how was the old campus life like, and how will it be in your own thinking? How will it be this time?
Okay, so let me just say, the old campus life is something that you can say is the normal life of a Ghanaian.
Yeah.
You know, Ghanaians are known to be very social people. We are very collective. We always want to get in touch with someone, you know, talk to somebody, hug somebody, you know, feel that connection.
So as Nigerians.
Well, let me just say Africans.
Yeah, sure.
Right. So in some way, that lifestyle is going to change, which comes to your question, the new life.
True.
You know, it's going to change. We are not going to be that social anymore. Mm. We might probably be calling ourselves Westerners from now on. You know, so in a way, it's going to affect the student body a lot. It's going to affect us in so many ways. It's going to affect us in it might even affect the way we learn, you know. It might affect quite a number of things that the normal student will call the everyday life. Mm. Yeah, but it's going to change that.
Okay. Yeah. Len.
Yeah.
What will happen? Just made a comparison for us on Knapsford then and now.
Knapsford then and now is get to campus, meet your friends after lectures, you meet people, hang out, boys meeting here and there to play football and having so much fun. But now you get to campus, first thing, you wash your hands, you get tested, you go to your classroom, you finish, and you are asked to go out, because already you've made measures that you'll be asked to go out, and you ensure you leave the campus. So it's not going to be so friendly as it was, which is going to have psychological impact on our students because people thrive on campus life.
Sure.
And that's not happening. So the new, we've never been there before. We are all hoping it gets better.
Mm. Yeah. Now to the overseer. How do you manage this? Now, you have seen several campus lives, over many campus, and how do you compare it to now, to the today campus life?
Well, thank you. Looking at how previous campus life used to be, it was fun, it was entertaining, it was very interactive. You get to meet new people each and every passing day. But I think this time is going to be more restricted. Movements and even classes would be more restricted, and everything you do, there will be check and balances. So I think this coming, going forward, I think campus life is going to be not that sociable. I think we are coming to live with our new normal now, where COVID-19 is going to stay with us for some bit of time. So now, I don't know, but I think that it's not going to be easy. It's going to be a whole different thing altogether.
You know, Kojo, you mentioned that it may affect the way we learn. How can you explain that now that we're going to be on campus, rules are going to be very, very rigid rules, and you have to abide with them? Like how Lim mentioned that we test you, if your time is up, you leave the lecture hall, you just don't stay for any other stuff. Can these things affect the way we may want to love learning? Because learning is all about openness and then willing to share. But this time, we may not be able to do all that. But how, to what extent can it affect learning?
If you look at it from the aspect of, you know, the average student, you might want to say, yes, it will affect the love for studies.
Sure.
But then, in my view, I don't think that should be the case, because there are so many interventions that COVID has brought into our state of living. For instance, I am working on a project currently, and we are able to meet on campus. So what we do is to use virtual learning or virtual platforms to have our meetings and then plan the way forward to, you know, get our things in place.
Great.
That is not usually the way for the average student.
Sure.
But in COVID, the situation now doesn't mean that you should go with the new normal. I mean, you should go with the way things were before.
Sure.
Now you need to adjust. That is how life is. I mean, it gets to a certain stage, you have to adjust to certain conditions. And that is what COVID has brought into our system. So if you are such a student who loves meeting people and then just standing there, you know, having all those conversations, you have to change.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody who doesn't like change is not ready to, you know, develop. You have to change. You have to make yourself available on maybe a platform that you would never have gone on before. I wasn't used to virtual learning, but COVID has made that opportunity available to me. And now I'm even loving it that I'm going to the classroom, I should say. Yeah.
Yo, so Lynn, tell us what things that have been done on campus that you think, you in your view, think can secure students, or if there are more.
Okay, on my campus, as everywhere else, we are getting tested here and there.
Okay.
We have so many nine sinks because we don't want Veronica buckets and people won't be attracted to it. So we have very nice sinks, which we will ensure everybody does their washing of hands, practicing social distancing. And psychologically, from my side, I've had gathering women who have will be interacting here and there to check up on each and everyone, because right now everybody thinks everything is getting normal, but it has had a great impact on people. So psychologically, I'm gathering my women to be talking to each other and see what is going on with each and everyone, and hopefully when we get the real course.
You know, you mentioned social distancing.
Yeah.
How do you ensure social distancing at every moment? Because, you know, people gather to see things. I mean, you're on campus.
Yeah.
So how can you social distance anywhere? Would you be there to do that?
Yes. Not practically me, but we have students who want to be part of the student body, the leadership, and we are employing all of those people to be each other's keeper and ensuring that students lead. It doesn't look so like it's going to be possible, but it's going to be possible because of how my campus is like. So for my campus, I can say it's possible that social distancing can be practiced, but I don't know for other campuses
because of the size of the campus.
Yes, you
are afraid for large campuses.
Yes,
you won't be everywhere to tell.
Yes,
so he can answer to that.
Yes, the campus.
So let's talk about the issue, ensuring that people are safe. What ought to be available on campuses from your point of view?
First of all, we would say that institutions need to make sure that there is centers for people who are going to be affected. There should be a place for isolation.
Great.
So that we don't know what might happen.
Okay.
Somebody might get affected. So there should be an isolation center on campus.
Okay.
Especially those who are going to be sleeping or who will be staying on campus. Mm-hmm. That is one. Two, we are going to make sure that student, we would encourage students or the administration to make Veronica buckets and water, hand sanitizers more available to students,
mm-hmm.
because we don't know who is carrying the virus, mm-hmm. and where he's coming from.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, if I'm having or I'm carrying the virus, the spread could be limited if there is more washing of hands, more using of sanitizers, and all wearing our nose masks. I think with all this, we are good to go. And secondly, it would be nice for institutions to, as we are saying, social distancing.
Sure.
When you are arranging desks on campuses, our cleaners, those who do the cleaning in our various lecture hall, they should ensure that there is a bit of social distancing in the arrangement of our chairs.
Okay.
With that, I think that it is going to give us a head start.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, the SRCs and even school management should always advise students or advocate or sensitize students that there is this virus still in the country. It's not gone. Mm-hmm. It's still in the country.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to protect ourselves. Protecting yourself doesn't mean the school has to come and protect you. You the individual, need to protect yourself.
Sure.
If you don't protect yourself, any way the school protects you cannot protect yourself. So we should protect ourselves. And with that, I think with that, we will be good to go.
Great. So we're still discussing the ways and means students can generate through COVID-19's repercussion on campuses. And it hasn't been easy, though, you know, because our leaders are just trying to, just protect themselves, though. Everybody wants to be safe, but we just need to put things in place to get students to be safe. So don't go anywhere. When we come back, we're talking about more on these policies and also provisions to keep you safe and secured. Don't go anywhere. Right back.
Are you an institution or individual? Do you intend to organize a memorable event to be archived for future reference? Then look no further than AAU Studios, because it's your best bet. With our spacious studio and state-of-the-art media equipment such as 4K Panasonic video cameras, KinoFlow lights, assorted microphones, live streaming equipment, among others, you are sure to get the best of productions. Visit us at Trinity Avenue, East Legon, adjacent the National Accreditation Board, or contact the AAU Studios via the following email addresses: info@aau.org, aautv@aau.org, or ransford@aau.org. Alternatively, you can call us on +233 244 736280.
You're welcome back to African Student Voice. Just joined us, it's African Student Voice, and we're discussing genuine true COVID-19 repercussion on campuses, and I have with my leaders in the house, and we're discussing how things should go. And let me just go to Kojo. Kojo, right now we have to try and then create more awareness on campuses, you know, and what ways can we create awareness on campus to help students be very, very conscious of this virus?
All right, so I'll keep it simple. You know, on campuses we don't have to be like government.
Mm-hmm.
Government is putting out information on radio, TV. They are expensive.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not something student body or schools, not almost all schools can do this, especially even the student representative council. We can't do that.
You can't afford it.
So I would suggest a very simple method. Just write measures to control the disease or measures to keep yourself safe. Just put it advantage points, maybe on the doors of classrooms or close to the whiteboard mark or something, or anywhere that you know that people will definitely be gathered. Just simple informations. Don't hug your friend. Don't stand too close, 2 meter distance and social distance. Don't go to the bedroom and then, you know, bring all your friends into the simple messages that will conscientize the students that these things will make them know that, okay, COVID is still around, but we still have to learn. And in that case, because the message is here every day, I'm seeing it, you know, it's keeping me aware of what is going on. I would always go back to the Bible. It says what? Faith comes by hearing the word of God.
Sure.
So if you are seeing this message each and every day, what does it mean? It means it's telling you that this is what you're supposed to do in a certain way. Like Lynn was saying, psychologically, it makes you aware of certain things that you have to take.
Okay.
I mean, certain measures you have to take.
But you know, one of the bad things that we shouldn't be doing is when students come together and assemble in that huge numbers, which you can't predict that it won't happen. We may clash at the forecourts at the compound together, and that is a very bad spot for COVID-19 because it can spread in a maze. What do you think can be done to stop all these things? One would say perhaps we should change the credit hours, or we should blend the learning so you have some time at home, you have some few little time on campus, much time at home, so we prevent students from coming together. I think it would be a good idea.
Let me just say it this way. I think it's even best nobody goes to campus. I would always advocate for that. I mean, stay at home and then do your studies. COVID-19, this disease has made online studies enjoyable. You know, when you have to study, your parents don't disturb you, your siblings don't come to your room just because they know you have to study. And then this disease has conscientized people. You know, it has told people certain things that they should be aware of. So in my case, you don't even have to go to school. But then there's that issue of people who are at a disadvantage, like people in rural areas who cannot come to campus and then, I mean, who cannot stay in their places and then use the internet. Yes. So in a certain way, I would have been very selfish. I would tell the student administration not to even open the school campus. So even if I had my way, I would tell the president, don't open the school campus. But then, looking at these people, we have to go back to campus, right? So those people, I would say those people should come to campus. And then, like Gabs was saying, the certain arrangements should be made in a certain way that will lead the fight. So when the people are even sitting in the classroom at such a point, you realize that in a way they are conscientized. They know that, okay, this is how the gap is supposed to be. Even after classes, I don't have to go into a crowded area. You know, like I also mentioned, you have to put these things at informations at vantage points. Let the people know that, okay, when the person closes from the classroom, you say don't go into crowded areas. In that person's mind, he's moving out of the class. There's another class coming out of their own classroom. So now what do I do? Do I move alongside them? Sure. Or I should wait for a number of... You see, some of these things, they are just common sense practices that you have to put in place. And I believe university students are, you know, smart enough to know certain things that they should do. We are not primary students, you know, we are not. So in a way, somebody will also argue that even Ghana is not so, not Ghana, African countries are not able to control their own people. There are so many mass gatherings and whatnot. But then you are a university student, that you have to know. First, that's the first thing you have to know. You tout yourself to be smart, and you have to make use of that smartness so that you don't spread the disease in uncontrollable ways. Yeah.
Lynn, you know, let me just refer you to the Ghana's intervention. So in Ghana,
we allow for a minimum number of public gatherings, maximum 100, mm-hmm. and the time you can spend is 1 hour, that's at church. Do you think in the lecture hall there will be a need to reduce the credit hour, or let's say lectures shouldn't go beyond an hour 30 minutes because it's a gathering? Or perhaps we have to reduce the number. A class, let's say 100, should be 50, part one and part two. Do you think we'll need these mechanisms to keep ourselves safe?
Yes, I think we need all these mechanisms. And I think governments, not only Ghana, other governments should be considering resuming very early, before September, because the large schools will need an extension of, even if it is 3 hours, the numbers should be reduced and they will need a lot of sessions within a day. So if it is 10 courses that happen in a day, it has to reduce maybe to five, and those sessions will have to be multiple. And people are also talking about the double, you have some in the classrooms and you have some online. I think that should be also employed, and we'll feel safe in that way.
Yeah, so deploying this blended form of learning where you can be in the lecture hall and also you can be online,
mm-hmm.
calls for this issue of data and devices. The University of Witwatersrand in South Africa provided 5,000 laptops to students who didn't have laptops, and provided 30 gigabytes of data for students who were during their examination time.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to presume full-time learning. It means that this will become an integral part of the billing, where data is provided, devices are provided. Would you suggest that universities should make plans or policies to provide devices to those who do not have, and data as well?
So I think universities have already done most of them have already done that, and they should also start considering reducing the fees, since some of the courses will be taken home and facilities in the schools won't be used, and we are mostly billed with those things. So they should start considering reducing fees, and people won't even think of the money they are using online, because if my fees has been reduced, it's okay, I don't have to complain much. So if they can also provide those laptops, fine. I think students loan, the last time I heard, is providing laptops alongside the money for students. So if any student is having those challenges and their school has not been able to provide, I think they can get to that. And student loan has to fulfill their promises.
Good. So I think the issue of student loan has to be looked into further, because many students don't know how to even assess that in the first place. So let me come to you, Eben. The issue of student leaders and their initiatives, we understand they've been a huge block because of COVID-19. Tell us a few about what student leaders have been trying to do during these times.
First of all, I'd like to say a big commendation to the Mother Union, that is NOOCS, and some other blocks, USAG, PUSAG. First of all, the Mother Union, in collaboration with most of the blocks, had what we call the NOOCS Food Bank,
mm-hmm.
where students who, during the lockdown period, students who were not able to go home and were on campus were given relief items. Private university students also had the opportunity of also doing the same. One way or the other, some of us are also doing the education on online.
Sure.
We have been able to have two webinars, one talking about after COVID-19, what role should a professional student have? Whether there is the opportunities there for the professional student.
Okay.
Then we also had a recent one, which actually was about the student leadership,
mm-hmm.
the way forward. Basically, we felt that as a union, we felt that most of the SRCs, we don't know how they are going to go about, because final year students who are normally position held holders. So because of that, we wanted to know what are their plans,
mm-hmm.
How are they leaving office, who is taking over from them,
mm-hmm.
what are the measures they have to put in place. But we came to the realization that some of them are planning to have an IMC which will take over from them. So that, because some of us, we also have to leave the system for others to also come and take their position. And we rely on SRC elections to run our elections.
Sure.
So with that, we had to know what the various SRCs are doing. Luckily for us, majority of our students or our students in local unions have been able to have an IMC.
Okay.
Some of them are almost done with their elections. So I think with that, I believe that Ghana, we are doing well.
Mm.
With I spoke to a colleague in Nigeria, and they don't seem to have they have a lot of issues with regard to how student leadership is going on in their country.
Okay.
So I think for Ghana, we will say a big thumbs up to most of the student unions.
Mm. You know, about to wrap up, but I want to ask you a question. If you were in the lecture hall now, all right, imagine you had a face-to-face one. Would you prefer a lecturer wearing a face mask, a nose mask, or a face shield? Tell me what you prefer. Could you? Nose mask or face shield?
Like I said, I wouldn't go to campus, but but then if I had to go, I think I would want this. If I had to go, I think I would see my lecturer. You know, the face.
The face.
Yeah, there's something about seeing a person's face and talking to that person. It gives you a certain relief, you know. I just imagine we sitting here and then you're looking at me with my nose mask on. And I'm smiling. How would you know I'm smiling? You know? Sometimes I think about all these things and I realize, Charlie, the life we had before was fun.
Sure.
But then moving forward, we just have to change certain things. So I would rather my lecturer use a face shield.
I got one good. All right, so face shield, nose mask.
Nose mask.
Okay, because you're going to nose mask.
Yes, I don't need to see my lecturer smiling.
Mm.
I need to understand that the new normal is getting to steady. I don't have to, I know that I'm not competing with only Ghanaians. I'm competing with people elsewhere. They are more advanced.
Okay.
So must I see my lecturer smiling? I need to be protected and I need to get the knowledge. So the nose mask is better.
Okay. The tie we're looking by you.
Oh really? Unfortunately,
short or nose mask.
Unfortunately, I'm leaving school, so
what would you recommend?
I'll go for the nose mask.
Nose mask.
Yes.
Electric nose mask.
Yes. I think. I love fashion, so basically, when you come with the face shield, it loses some bit of weight to me, but with the nose mask, now it's kind of fashion, so. I like them as well.
Okay, we'll take it like that, you know. So I hope you enjoy the discussion, and you know, you can also have your own out there, face shield or nose mask, which one should be available for students to use, and using lecturers to have studies going on. But we know we discussed that we'll have a more of a blended learning whereby you can be at home to study or on campus. But most importantly, the prime person responsible for your safety is you. So you have to make sure you have your hands washed under running water with soap, and also your face mask, your nose mask, face shield, hand sanitizers, all these things must be with you. And don't forget social distancing. As we prepare to go back to school, we should have all these things in our mind. So Kojo, thank you very much, Len Willis and Gabson. Thank you very much for your time and the time you spent with students in Africa on how to keep themselves safe for the next semester. And they'll forever remain glad that they had this from you. Thank you very much for your time. My name is Ajimor Chidakwon, it's African Student Voices. Follow us on social media on Facebook and YouTube, and also send me more comments. Have a nice day and bye.